In two of my previous video tutorials, I have been shown how to send an email with PHP Mailer class. But the problem with those videos is that there is now a new version of PHP Mailer, and now those videos are not good enough anymore. So for that reason, in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to send an email with an attachment using PHP Mailer version 6, and also I'm going to show you how to send on two ways, normal email and sending via SMTP. So let's do it. Hey, what's up guys? It's Nate here from CodePassiveIncome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they would do it on their own. So if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So now I'm here at my PHP store and I have created a new project, and also I have two folders and one new file. So first thing that we are going to do is let's just create some basic HTML form. So I'll create a new document. I'll say here contact form. And now I'm just going to include Bootstrap library so that we can create nice looking contact form. Okay, I will use the CDN link. I'm not going to download it. Okay, and we just need to paste it just before closing head tag. Okay, so now inside the body we are going to have one div and with class container, and inside this container we are going to have one row. And let's say I will just justify everything to the center. Okay, and inside this row I will have one column, and then I want to set an offset for this column so that it will be in the center. So how am I going to do that? So let's say this column will be MD6, and since we know that in the Bootstrap there's 12 columns, I will set offset 3. Okay, so that from the both side we have the same offset. And then here I will set align to the center, and maybe let's set margin top for our container 100 pixels. Okay, so at top of this column I will just include my logo.png. Okay, I will make two new lines, and then I'm going to create one new form here. So let's say I will use method post, and I'm going to use action this file. Okay, so now inside this form I will have one input. Let's say the name will be subject. I'll set also placeholder subject. Okay, new line. And then I'm going to duplicate this. I will set this one to the email. I will set type to the email, and I will set placeholder to the email. So after that I will just make one text area, and for this text area I will set name message. Okay, and I will set here new line. And let's just add one submit button. So I'll say type submit value send email. Okay, and maybe we should also have one input with the type file, and let's say the name will be attachment. Okay, so this is just very basic design, nothing special. So maybe it will be good if we set for each of those I'll set class form control. So this class is from the Bootstrap. I will do the same for text area. Okay, and maybe for this text area we can also set placeholder message. Okay, So let me now just quickly upload this and we will see what we have. Okay, fresh. And here we go. So this is one very basic design. Maybe we can also for this input set class to the BTN primary. Okay. And that's it. So now the next thing that we need to do is we need to accept all those informations. So I'll write my PHP code here at the top. Okay. And I will say if isset post, and now I want to check if, so we are missing here submit, so I want to check if someone has clicked on this button. So if it exists this submit, okay, we will just accept all the information. So I will say name is post. Sorry, man. We don't have a name, we have a subject. Subject. After that, we have email. We have message. And also, there is an attachment, but we need first to set this form type to the multi-part form data if we want to send an attachment, and then we need to accept this attachment. So how we are going to do this? First, let me show you what this exactly means. So in the global variable files, the PHP will store everything, all the informations about this file. So I will just quickly show you how it looks like so that you know what am I talking about once I start writing the code. So now when we refresh, I'll hit here choose file. I will use whatever this file is. Hit open, send email, and now here is what we have got from this. So as you can see, this is an array, and inside this array we have attachment, and this attachment is array again, and for this attachment we have name, which is watch.png. After that we have type of the file, we have temporary name where it is upload, we have an error, and we also have a size of this image. So what is at the moment important for us is only the name. I have another tutorial on my channel where I'm talking about how to do different things with attachments. So how to verify the size, the type, etc, etc. But for this tutorial, it's really not important. So we only want to get attachment and then the name of the file. So how we are going to do that? Let's say first we want to define where we are going to upload our file. So I will upload to the folder attachment, and then here I will get the name from the files variable. So I will just use a function base name. It will just help us. So I will use files, and then we have attachment, and then we also have a name. Okay, so now how we are going to upload, we will say move uploaded file, and then we need to specify what we are uploading. So we have files attachment, and then we can see here that we have temporary name. So this is where our file currently is. So I will copy this, paste, and then we are going to upload it to the file. So let's quickly try that, just to make sure that we know how to upload file to our folder. Okay. Now let's try to upload again, continue. There is nothing, but now let's check, do we have anything inside our attachment folder? And as you can see now, there is a watch.png file. Okay, so I will just delete that one. So this part is working. Okay, so what we can do here, we can say that if iset files, so if there is some file, we are going to upload this file. Okay, and let's say else file equal empty. Okay, and we can say here echo file, just to make sure again what will happen. So continue, and now as you can see we have a file. And if we didn't have a file, if I just hit send email, it will just say attachment and okay, so maybe we should say here if we set files. Attachment and then also name. Okay, so refresh. And also we need to check if the name of the file is empty. So if it's not empty, it means that there is some file. So quickly, let's make a test again. Okay, so now if we hit send email, it's empty, and if we choose some file, there is a name. Okay, so this is just one way on how to upload file. And also the goal with this if condition is that we are checking so that when we start sending an email, we won't send any attachment if there isn't one, and if there is one, we will make sure that it is going to be sent. Anyway, so now in order to send an email, all we need to do is to download and include phpMailer class. So first I will go to the Google and then I will search for phpMailer. I will go here. And then I'm going to clone or download, and I will hit this button. So I will just find my project. Okay, it's here. And then I will hit save. Okay, so I will just, it's here. So I will extract everything to this folder, delete this archive. And then all I need to get is this source folder. So I will copy paste here, delete this one. Okay. And then let's just rename this file. Okay. So now inside this folder phpMailer, we have some classes. But now with this new version, in order to use phpMailer, first we need to get a namespace. So I will say phpMailer, okay. And now if I write the code here, as you can see now, PHP store is saying that it can't be included here. So now this is something that you always have to keep in mind if you are using something different than PHP store. Because in, for example, Sublime Text, Atom or any other, you will not get any notification about this. Okay, so now here, or we can do it at the top too, I will just, let's say, include once, and then I'm going to include the phpMailer class. Okay, so now here I will say, I will create new variable mail, and I will say new phpMailer. Okay, and here now first let's send an email that is not sent via SMTP. So how we are going to do this, I will say that first we need to set an address where we are sending this email. So let's say I will set it to the codingpassiveincome.com. Okay, and now we need to set from, so who is sending this email. So the person that is sending is this email, and then we can also specify the name of this person, but at the moment we don't know that. So we need to set subject. So the subject, we can use the one that Avistar has written, and then we need to set is HTML. Let's say it's true, so it will be HTML email. And we need to set body. Okay, so for the body, I will just say this is whatever the person has typed in. Okay, and the last thing that we need to do is we need to add attachment. So I'll say add attachment, and then I will just specify our file. That's it. Now we can call the function and say that if mail send, we'll say, let's say we'll have at the top one variable message, and then here I will say message, your email has been sent, thank you, else message is please try again. Okay, and now I will just display that message right here. So I'll say if message not empty, echo message and two new lines. Okay, so let's now try this. So I'll hit send email, refresh. I will upload PHP mailer too. Let's wait a few seconds. Okay, so let's refresh this. So what is the problem? Okay, and then let's try like this. So let's see what will happen now. Now it says that there isn't a file. PHP mailer. So we made a small mistake. Okay. So everything is looking good now. Okay. So now let's try to write some subject. Test email. Let's say I'm sending from this, and this is some message. And let's say at the moment I won't use any attachment. So I will hit send email. And now what does it say? So it looks that we didn't include an exception class. So let's say I will just include once PHP mailer, and then we will include the exception class. So let's quickly try to upload again. Refresh. And now it says your email has been sent, thank you. So let's check our inbox folder. And here we go. So here's our email, and this is some message. So I will delete this one. And now let's try to send an email, basically the same one with some new message, but this time we are going just to include some attachment. So hit send email, and now it says again your email has been sent. You have got a new email and also there is some attachment. Okay, cool. So now the last thing that we need to do is we can send an email also via SMTP. So now in order to send an email via SMTP, all those things will be pretty much the same. The only difference is that we need to just include some other things here that so that we will let know to the PHP mailer that we want to send an email via SMTP. So the first thing, so I will maybe make a comment here, if we want to send via SMTP. Okay, so first thing that we need to do is, let's say I will set a host. So our host will be, in my case, I will use smtp.gmail.com. Okay, after that we need to say is SMTP. So this one here, it all depends from the hosting. So on some you need to include this line and on some you shouldn't. So we will see what will happen in my case. After that, of course, we need to set authentication to the true. Okay, then we need to set a username from which we are going to send an email. So let's say I will use this one. Okay, then we need to set a password. So to be honest, I don't know what is my password. So I'll quickly go to the mail. And then here I have a software that is dynamically creating a password for me. So I'll just copy and then I will paste it here. So you can see how it looks like. Okay, then we need to set the secure type. So here we have two options. We can set SSL or we can set TLS. So it all depends what do you want. It is almost no difference. I'm going to use SSL and then I'm going to set a port. And now you have to remember that for SSL the port is 45465 and then for TLS if you ever used is 587. Okay, and pretty much this is all that you need to set. So host, this is SMTP, the authentication, username, password, the SMTP secure and the port. So let's now try to send again by using SMTP this time. So I'll just upload again. Okay. And let's try just to refresh, continue. And now it says that we are missing an SMTP class. So let's at the top include that one too. So I'll say here SMTP PHP. Okay, so upload, refresh, continue. And now it says please try again. And I guess that in my case the problem is with this line of the code. So I can just comment this, but before I do that, let me show you how you can debug what actually is wrong. So instead of showing this please try again, let's try to show something specific. So I'll say echo mail and then we have error info. Okay, so I will just save and now when this time we refresh it will show what its problem. So it's a SMTP connect failed. Okay, and here we have a link where we are able to read more about this problem. So I think that in most cases the problem is with this line here, so we just need to comment and let's try again. So refresh, continue, and now it says your email has been sent, thank you. So let's see, are we going to receive a new email? Okay, and here we go. So this time the only difference is that we have sent an email via SMTP. So you always need to keep in mind about this part here, and it all depends on the hosting type that you have at the moment. So now each time, as you can see here in our attachment folder, there is always a file uploaded, and basically if you don't need those files each and every time, you can just down here, if or if it's not, it doesn't matter, you can just write one line of the code and say unlink and then specify the file. And basically this function is going to delete this file each and every time. Okay, so that's it. If you want to send an via SMTP, use this. If not, just remove this part and that's it. So guys, I hope that you have enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like it and share it to your friends. And also, if you have any kind of question, please ask in the comments below and I will make sure to answer all of them. Take care.